every minute of every day, someone in the world is buying a pair of Steve Madden shoes. The man behind the brand created his shoe empire in 1990 with just $1,100. He sold his shoes out of the boot of his car, and today the Steve Madden brand is valued in the billions. Now the legendary designer is relaunching into Australia. Here to tell us more is the man himself, Steve Madden.
Good morning, hey. Steve.
What's happening?
Mate, when did you become obsessed with shoes? And do you put your success down to planning or luck?
Well, you know, I'm all the way around the world in New York, so I've been making shoes since I'm in high school. I went to work in a shoe store as a kid.
Wow.
Oh, that's my daddy. That's great.
As a bit of a shoe aficionado, you have my absolute and full attention. How soon afterwards, when you started making shoes, as we mentioned, out of the boot of your car, you started in a shoe shop, how did you, in the Big Apple, make it work?
You know what? I was very lucky. I had a lot of great people that I worked with, and I had a lot of energy in those days. And one thing led to another. It seemed to... discovered a customer base that wasn't being taken care of, which was like the what they call the Gen Xers back then.
You've had some bumps along the way, including some time in prison for fraud. You had to resign as CEO. How do you bounce back from something like that?
Oh, my God, that picture, don't show that.
Okay,
I'll never be allowed to go to Australia. I'll be banned from the country. No, I did. I got involved with some childhood friends and... made some mistakes, and I did a couple of years in prison. They raised money for my company, and it's something I deeply regret. And, you know, they made a movie about it.
They did.
I don't know if you guys...
Yeah, Wolf of Wall Street,
The Wolf of Wall Street. Yeah, The Wolf
of
Wall Street.
Really weird watching your life play out in a movie. Tell me what that experience was like.
Oh, my God, there I am. It was very strange to relive that moment. But I'm very grateful for all that's... Even though I deeply regret prison and the mistakes that I made, I'm very grateful for where I am today and the path that led me to where I am today. Everything had to happen a certain way for me to be here talking to you today. And... all the lessons and hard lessons, so I'm sort of grateful.
I imagine the prison issue shoes weren't too good, so you would have been good to get back outside. How many shoes should the average woman own, and what are the must-haves?
I don't think you can ever have enough shoes.
Yes, I agree.
I think you've got two people.
And by the way, this is the big baseball team in New York, the New York Yankees.
Yep.
I just wanted to wear that for everybody in Melbourne for them to see.
You've been making shoes for us for a very long time. You've got to keep on trend. What do women want?
God, if I knew what women wanted, I wouldn't have gotten divorced. So, well, we seem to have a knack for making shoes that girls like to buy, so I'm happy about that.
One of the biggest trends at the moment is the dress sneaker, and sales of sneakers are on the rise. You've got some great ones there. What do you look for when you're dressing sneakers to go out in, if you like, not just for exercise?
If you can wear a sneaker with a dress, you got something.
And I got to tell you, I am loving it because I've always worn a lot of high heels, but this whole sneaker and the bling
what a great shoe.
Things, the bling things that
yes,
are coming
the
in,
bling thing.
I adore. So how much bling
thing.
Do
yes.
you look like to put yeah. on your shoes?
Yeah, well, not always, but, you know, in that particular shoe, it looks good. But we've been known to put ornamentation on shoes.
What makes a shoe comfortable if it's a stiletto?
Well, I would say to you guys that platforms are generally more comfortable than non-platform shoes.
I agree.
And because they, you know, there's a place for the ball of the foot to rest.
Steve, do you actually
we
try
to make our high heels comfortable?
Do you
put a little extra padding in the shoes.
What do you think about these, Steve?
So that's a great shoe. Now that has a hidden platform in the front of the shoe, so it's the foot has a place to rest.
Have you ever worn high heels so that you understand what it feels like? Have you ever actually tried a pair on and worn them for a day?
I actually did wear platform shoes in the 70s, really high ones. It was 1975, 1976. Everybody wore platform shoes. So I do know what it's like. and it's pretty weird.
But you do feel super tall.
I'm glad I don't have to wear them. Yes. You guys are silly over there in Australia.
You're absolutely right.
No, I think it's a legitimate question. A man who designs shoes should know what they feel like to wear all day. Now, you're known to visit Steve Madden's stores. You're about to open two new retail stores right here and a dedicated Australian online shopping platform for the first time. Tell us about them and any chance where you're going to pop into the Melbourne or Gold Coast shops?
I'm dying to come to Australia. The Australians are making such a big mark in fashion in America. Everywhere you go, all you hear about is this Australian line and that Australian line. So I'm dying to come and see what it's all about. It's a long trip for me, though. I have young kids, so.
Hey, it's a movie to a glass of wine, a meal, and a movie. That's all it is.
Yeah, a couple of glasses of wine.
You can do it.
Yeah.
Well, the new Steve Madden.
You think I could do it? How long is it? By the way, how long is it to New York to Australia?
22 hours to Sydney.
Yeah.
22 hours to Sydney.
Oh, my God. Are you kidding me?
5 to LA, 14 to Sydney.
Don't panic, Steve. Don't panic. But if you go through Dallas, you might be able to do the direct.
The what?
If you go through Dallas.
Oh, can you take.
Yeah. You can go direct New York, Dallas. It's all right. We'll sort out the your flight arrangements. Hey, it is so good to talk to you. Since I lived in New York, I remember your shoes and your name so well. So it's such a pleasure to put a person to the fabulous shoes.
And it was so nice to meet you guys. I loved coming on, and I can't wait to come to Australia.
We can't wait for you to get here.
I can't wait to see Melbourne. Yes.
Well, the new Steve Madden stores open on Saturday at Melbourne's High Point Shopping Centre. That's where you can pop into, Steve. And at Robina Town Centre on the Gold Coast on the following Saturday. The online store is live now. Head to stevemadden.com.au. Thank you, Steve.
Thank you.